Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm going to show you all the fuses and relays location on this Opel Corsa C from 2003. Also, I'm going to show you how to test them, how to use them in your favor, in your advantage, instead of seeing them like an obstacle, like something complex, because that's the main purpose of these components, is to make diagnosing any issue a little bit easier. So coming from the front of the car, the fuse box is located on the driver's side. You just press on this tab and release the cover. On the back of the cover, you've got all the fuses numbered, and you've got number one on the top right down here. If you remove this little extra cover, you're gonna find fuse number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it goes like this. All right, so as you watch from the left side, from the driver's side, let's see one by one all the fuses and relays. Inside the fuse box, you're gonna find this little plastic plier to remove the fuses. If you don't find this, you can use any sort of plier, like a small size, and make sure that you do not squeeze so much the fuse while you pull it. This material can be quite brittle and it will crack, and you don't want that to damage a fuse which is good. Right, so let's start with this group of fuses. And we've got fuse number one for the central control unit. That's basically a part of the dashboard. Fuse number two, the engine control unit. That's basically for the computer stuff. Fuse number three, you've got the dashboard control, some of the controls of the dashboard. Fuse number four is the number plate light in the back. So let's see a couple of tests, for example, you can do on these number plate lights. We already know that all the fuses in general, actually most of them, I never seen fuses on the negative side. So all the fuses are on the positive side. It means on the red line, on the red wire, the plus. So basically a fuse will not allow a maximum current to pass through them, like this one has 5 amps. So if 6 amps will pass through this fuse, the fuse will blow. And the purpose of that is to protect the circuits, the wires inside these wiring harnesses. Since, as you can see, for example, you don't want to search the number plate light wire into this wiring harness because it's gonna be very, very difficult. If, for example, there is water in the circuit, so if, for example, in the back in the number plates you've got some water, that water will allow the current to overcharge, like to get extra current, extra amperage on it. Therefore, when you turn on the number plate lights, the current will break the wire at the weakest point, and the weakest point can be anywhere along the wiring harness. So as you can see, I removed the fuse from the number plate. I inspect it, it's okay, it's not blown. I'm gonna set it apart, and let's say that the fuse is okay and the light is still not working. When you turn on the lights, you can turn your voltmeter to 20 volts. I'm gonna put the car keys in the ignition, turn it in the second position like that. If I turn on the lights, the number plate light is not on. If I put back the fuse in the number four slot, the number plate light is on. So let's say that the fuse is good and the number plate light is still not on. Then I'm gonna remove again the fuse, take my voltmeter, set it to 20 volts direct current. I've got the negative and the positive on these sides, and you can see we've got 12 volts, but it's inverted. So I'm gonna switch the terminals to the right position. Okay, so one information you can find in this way with this voltmeter is to find out which of the pin, which one of these two connections is the part where it's connected to the battery, and which part is connected, is going to the part you are testing, like in our case is the number plate light. The wire, the pin from the negative one is going to the light, and this plus is coming from the battery. I will remove the voltmeter from the slot. I will turn it to amps mode. Since I know that this pin goes to the part, I'm gonna connect one terminal. I'm gonna take the other terminal, doesn't matter if it's red or black, because right now I've got a jumper cable in my hand with a gauge which will read exactly the amperage. So I'm gonna connect the other terminal to the positive terminal of the car battery. And right now we've got 0.6 amps, I hope you can see that. Of course, are used by the number plate light, which is now running without a fuse. What I did, I just basically jumped, I bypassed the fuse and I connected directly to the car battery, and that's how I can see, I can test if the circuit is good from the fuse box to the part, if the part will work, but when you put the fuse on, it doesn't work. Then in that situation, what you can do is you take your voltmeter, and I will go to continuity test. So I will switch the probe on this pin on the fuse box. So if I put my voltmeter to volts reading again and turn it to continuity mode, I should be able to find continuity between this point and the 12 volts on the car battery. It is, we've got continuity. It means there is 12 volts supplied to the fuse box. So with that being said, let's go ahead and present you the next fuses. For the number 5, we've got power windows on the driver side. If you find, for example, empty slots like here, your car doesn't have some options, so it's nothing to worry about. Like, for example, when you take a fuse and place it in the wrong position, it will not damage anything because these are not connected to anything. 6 and 7 are missing. The number 8 fuse is for the radio and CD player inside the cabin. Number 9 we've got for injection system, fuel pump and auxiliary heater. Number 9 fuse is for the injection system, fuel pump and auxiliary heater. Number 10 is for the horn. Number 11 is for the central control unit. That's mostly about the dashboard. There are a lot of options on the dashboard, like adjusting the volume, adjusting a lot of things. So you're gonna find a lot of fuses about the central control unit. 12 and 13 are missing. We've got 14, which is for the side mirrors. This car has power side mirrors. Number 15, we've got windshield washer system. Number 16, we've got fuse for the lights inside, like doom lights and stuff like that. Number 17 is for the central control unit. Number 18 is for the sunroof, if you have it. 19 is missing. Fuse number 20 is for the power window on the right side, on the passenger side. 21 is missing. Fuse number 22 is for the immobilizer, the safety feature which will lock the steering wheel. Fuse number 23 is for the windshield wiper motor. We've got 30 amps, it's a lot of amperage there. Fuse 24 is for the information system on the dashboard, like the warning lights. Fuse number 25 is for the braking lights. Fuse number 26 is for the reverse lights and the cigarette lighter. Fuse number 27 is for the heated seats in the right. And fuse number 28 is for the heated seats in the left. 29 is for the wiper on the back window. Fuse number 30 is for the engine control unit. 31 is missing. 32 is for the ABS. 33 for the engine control system. They can be the sensors on the cars, or there are a lot of things that can be on this. So it's worth checking up all these engine control units when you have a problem with any of the sensors on your car. 35, we've got the sunroof and the power windows. These can be something for the control unit, for those like the module. We are done with this group of fuses. Now let's move to these ones. We've got a couple of more in this side. Number 36, low beam left. Number 37, low beam right. Number 38, left backlights, park lights. And number 39, right backlights and right park lights. Number 40 is missing. 41 is missing. Number 42 for the fog lights. Number 43 for the high beam left. And number 44 for the high beam right. Fuse number 45, we've got this big fuse with 30 amps. This is for the air conditioned blower inside the cabin. We've got 46, again, engine control unit. This big 20 amps fuse. We've got 47 for the rear window defroster. This is the one which will make the rear window clear of condensation. Number 48 is for the engine starter, the one which will start the engine. Number 49 we got for APC, and number 50 is for the ABS. On this side you'll have for the air condition. And then we've got the 52 fuse, again it's for the air condition. However, if you have 30 amps fuse in here, it means you have air condition which will blow cold air in a warm environment. This car doesn't have such things, so we've got 20 amps only. So yeah, these are pretty much all the fuses on this car. Now let's get to the relays. So So the first relay on this side is for the fan, the radiator fan down there. Luckily on this relay you have the graph and you can read exactly what the pins will do. So we've got the electromagnet on pin 86 and pin 85, which are these two pins. So basically when you apply 12 volts with a low current on these two pins, it will allow the switch to complete the circuit and therefore the fan will start. So the reason of these relays is to use low current to help switch some parts which will use a lot of current, like the fan can use around 5 amps. Instead of switching direct on the 5 amps, which can be not dangerous, but it can damage the circuits over time if you overload them, you want to protect the switching side more because they are gonna be harder to get access to, since these are connected to the computer and it's gonna be much more difficult to remove the wires from the computer than it is to remove the wires from this box to the fan. There are less parts involved and less chances to do a mistake when you do this job. So that's also one of the purposes of the relays. And now if I'm using my 12 volt battery, on which you guys laughing on, if I energize basically the electromagnet, we should be able to see continuity, which will complete the test on this relay and it will prove that it works. So we've got the voltmeter connected. Now let's apply the 12 volts and here it comes. We've got full continuity through those pins. It means this relay is fully working. Another thing you can do on the relay side is to basically activate the part without the control unit to work. Again, if we look on this diagram on the relay, we can see that pin 87 and pin number 30 is the switching side. So basically, if I'm gonna jump the pin 87 and pin number 30, I'm gonna be able to start the fan without doing anything else. Of course, the key should be in the second position in the ignition. And you can see the radiator is on. That's also another shortcut, very useful shortcut when you test some parts. For example, one thing can go wrong with the fan is when the relay will get stuck open or closed. The next relay is the computer relay, the ACU relay. And I can tell you this one is very warm because it's activated since the key is in the second position. This relay is to be checked if none of the electronics works. Next one in the corner here is the fuel pump relay. So basically the same things will apply as for the radiator fan relay. I can demonstrate you, we've got pin 87 and pin number 30. Here is a much clearer diagram and we've got pin 87, pin number 30 are for the switch. And you can probably hear it. Again, very useful to do that when you do a fuel pressure test or any other fuel related system test. Next relay is for the defroster on the rear window. Next relay is for the blower motor inside the cabin. You can actually see the terminals which will complete the part circuit are much thicker compared to the control unit. One more thing to mention is that on these parts which use high current, like the blower motor, the starter especially, it's a good idea to not use the voltmeter to measure the amps because the voltmeter is limited to 10 amps. These parts will use much more than 10 amps, especially the starter, which is the next. So again, on this starter relay, it's the same principle basically. The next relay is basically for the all the electronics, like the throttle body, the mass airflow sensor and stuff like that. So without this relay, you'll not be able also to run the engine properly. You can actually hear it when I connect back the relay. The fuel pump is activated and everything else. Finally, guys, we've got these relays for the lights. So we've got the top one is for the back brake lights. This one is for the high beam. This one is for the parking lights left. This one is for the parking lights right. And this one is for the low beam. Alright guys, so that was pretty much it. I hope this video is gonna be useful in your situation when you diagnose different parts on the car. Check out the other videos I made about this car. There's gonna be a link in the description below with a playlist. And until next time, drive safe so I can see you soon.